This is the Tapo application for the Tapo C120 indoor-outdoor camera. Here we can see the Tapo page as we land on it. We'll list out all of our devices. In the upper right-hand corner, you could see a little bell icon with a red dot that indicates that I have an event notification that I should go check out. And here you could see my Tapo devices, and if I select one, it will bring me into what the type of trigger was. So in this case, I have a pet trigger, and if I select this, it will bring me in and show me the pet trigger. There is another way to access that area, but I wanted to show it to you so you knew what that was when we start things off. Coming down, if you have any routine set up, that's where you would see it, but we're gonna concentrate on the camera and what it can do. First being this icon right here, this means that the camera is on and viewing things. If I tap, and I'll use this one as an example, I have now put the camera into privacy mode. Tapping it again will make the camera blue and then boot itself up so that you can actually view and have it record things that are going on. If I select the camera, we are brought into the main screen for the camera. Starting at the top, we have the name of the camera. Under that, an extra item that we can add, which is the connectivity. Those are our settings. We'll come back to those later. This is the live feed from my camera. If I double tap, it will automatically zoom to its furthest point. Double tapping again, pulls it back. You can also pinch to zoom if you wanna slowly bring the camera into focus. I do wish that the double tap kinda incrementally brought it in instead of the full zoom length. Lower left-hand corner right here, we could see a box that has a grid. If I select this, this is one of the interesting things that Tapo does, which will allow me to add other Tapo cameras that I happen to have up. So if I select this one and add, now, from this view, I can have multiple cameras in a single feed. Granted, that's my battery powered one and it is in privacy mode currently, but I could add them. And if I select and hold, we could see I could have them in a grid of four. Tapping there brings me back to this view. Auto, well, this is the night mode. So auto between day and night, I could set it for night mode. I could set it for day mode only. I like it on auto so that it automatically changes between the two. Right here, this is one way that we can make our screen automatically bigger. And if I bring that up, you'll notice that we have some extra icons over there. Those are all accessible right down here as we're moving along. First being, that is a photo. If I take that, it's going to take a still snapshot of whatever it sees currently and add that to the gallery. Likewise, if I select this, this is going to be a video recording of what's going on. So everything that would happen right now is being recorded. Stopping that will save that to my playback and downloads area, so my gallery. Next to that, we have our microphone. This is going to be the camera's microphone and how sensitive it is. You can mute that if you'd like, but just know, I know that's a little confusing because it looks like a volume control, but it's not for audio, it is for the microphone. Here we have a two-way call, so this is full duplex. I can select this to tap to call, and now my cats can hear me. I have icons here, which is mute my mic, so I could turn that on and off, and then I can mute the speaker on and off. I'm going to end this call and send that away. You'll notice in the upper right-hand corner there were some extra options. Well, those extra options are also available on our talk. In order to utilize this, though, we have to press and hold in order for the audio to be sent through the camera. Here are those controls that I talked about. Selecting them, we have our slider for the camera's microphone as well as the camera speaker. So that's both on the full duplex area as well as the push to talk area. Next, we have our alarm. This does not automatically set the alarm off. This tells the camera that if you see motion, that you're going to trigger the alarm that sounds like this. Privacy mode, as we talked about on that front screen, we can toggle that on and off from there, but we can also do that here. If I select privacy mode, well, now it's in privacy mode. I can't see anything. The camera is inactive. It will not record. Simply tapping it brings us back into our live feed. Here we have our light. This camera is equipped with two LED lights. If I toggle that on, you can actually see because my room is a little dark there. By default, it will stay on for 5 minutes. I can turn that off if I want to, and there you can see the LEDs turn themselves off. Here we have tag mode on and off. What this will do is if there's somebody walking through your scene, if it's a pet, if it's a person, if it's a vehicle, there will be a box around them labeling them as such. So you will always know what's in your scene. This is only in the live view. This is not part of the recording, but I have tested it where it has tracked two people and a pet very easily, which I was very impressed with. Next, we have our Tapo Care. Selecting Tapo Care brings us into the, hey, maybe you want to pay for some extra features. You have a monthly charge or yearly charge, if that's what you prefer, and it gives you some options and Q&A. What you'll get with Tapo Care, if you choose to use it, you get 30-day unlimited cloud storage, rich text notification with Snapshot, and Smart Sort, allowing you to sort based on specific triggers that have happened. I will admit, aside from the rich notification, everything else that the camera does for free is more than suitable for most people. Coming down, we have our playback and downloads. If I select this, this again is one of the things that I really like about Tapo, in that you get a lot for free. And we've got triggers. You could see pet, person, and right here, we have a timeline. So I have this set up for 24/7 recording. So this blue space is where nothing is happening. And if I come in here, now we start getting to triggers. So here you could see me walking around feeding my cats, but you can also pinch to zoom in on the timeline so that you can get really granular with what you're actually trying to look at. There you can see me walking around. With the playback, we also get the option for speed up here in the upper right-hand corner. We can have this go as slow as 1/16th or all the way up to 16 times speed so that you don't have to scrub through this watching it go slowly. And here you can see there's a cat, but no tag around him because that was only for the live feed. Tapping our image again, we do have the ability to zoom in. There you see, there's my other cat, a little grainy because I zoomed all the way in, but we can pause the recording right from here. We can toggle the sound for the recording. We can take a snapshot of the recording. And then if we wanted to, we can press play and record what we're actually seeing on screen. And then it saves just that little snippet to the recorded area. We have the scissor icon. If I select it, it will allow me to clip down this 3-minute clip, because this is a very long clip, but I can actually select how much of this clip I actually want. So from 3 minutes, I'm making it 120. There you can see I made it a minute. Clip and download. And now that will download just that portion of that very long segment to the downloads area. The one problem with it is that you need to be on the same Wi-Fi network as the camera in order to be able to use that tool. Any one of these clips, if I wanted to download it without having to use that clip or record feature, I can simply select the three dots and select download, and it will move that to my downloaded spaces. Here I have a timeline. If I select this, this is a calendar, and the calendar, when it has a dot, lets you know, hey, there's something that you should go look at. If I select my downloads area, this is gonna show me everything that I've downloaded. So here's some things that I did yesterday. Here's what I was downloading as we were going through this review, and then downloads completed. It says 2 of 2, so I know those are done. I can select my three dots here. I can filter, and I can filter for photo, video, cloud videos, video summary, favorites, unfavorite something. Selecting my dots, I can select and individually select to share, favorite, download, or delete. And that's all under our downloads area. Underneath that, we have our Tapo Care. This is if you paid for the Tapo services, you would see your cloud videos there. And those are all of our camera controls and features. But in the upper right-hand corner here, if I select this icon, this is a sprocket, this brings us into the settings. And there are a lot of settings that you get with Tapo cameras that you might not have expected to get with a camera at this price point. Starting off at the top, area to change your name, device information, firmware, things of that, some other sensitive information, we're not gonna get into there. Moving down, we have detection. We have the ability to set up detections for motion, person, pet, vehicle, line cross. A lot of other things do that, but what Tapo does is if I select this, I have the ability to set where I want each of these to be. So if I select edit again, this is my motion zone, maybe pet zone. If I select pet, by default, I get the entire area, but maybe my pets just really shouldn't be over in this corner. So now I have motion zone for everything. I have a pet zone just over there, and I could do that with vehicle, which is currently turned off, but I could do person. Oh, person, maybe I only care about this over here in the hallway. Just notify me there. So now I have three different zones for three different activities. I can delete a zone, I can clear all the zones, I can also put the phone into landscape mode, and for each of these, I can add multiple zones. As you can see, I could just keep going, and you could do that for all areas. This is one of the standout features that you get with Tapo. And here, if I wanted to, for each of these, you can toggle on or off, and then the sensitivity. Line crossing is another interesting feature, which I don't need in my house, but if I turn this on, it will allow me to select if somebody crosses this line right there, let me know. And then you could switch direction. Right now, it goes both ways. If I select that, only tell me if it goes this way or tell me if people go that way. It is another feature. And then again, just like before, we can add a whole bunch of these. Hey, when do we want to be notified? When do we want this to happen? So we simply select edit, and then I could start changing my schedule. I'll leave that alone. The line crossing, just like the detection settings here, is another standout feature that Tapo has over other cameras. Tapo has also introduced a great deal of beta sound features. Do you want to be notified of baby crying, glass breaking, dog barking, cat meowing? There are not a lot of cameras out there that do a cat meowing, and that I find very useful because I don't have dogs, I have cats. Here we have another area to turn on and off our alarm. So again, it's not going off right now. It will only go off if motion is detected. But here we could set alarm type, light, sound, or both. Sound type, we've got default, but we've got a couple other extra options, and then the volume. We have the ability to change this. Just know if you hit that play button, it plays on the camera itself, not on the phone. I kind of wish they had the preview through the phone. Alarm duration, by default, just it goes until the motion is cleared, or we can say 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 30 seconds, or fully custom, and then go all the way up to 30 seconds. Alarm event type, if I select this, well, here you go. What do you want to have it trigger that alarm? And then we have our schedule. All day, during the evening, or custom, which is always great. Here we have another area to access our Tapo Care if we wanted to. Next, we have storage and recording. Well, guess what? You can put a micro SD card in here. Strongly recommend using micro SD card. Selecting this will allow you to format and set your SD card for loop recording. It will also tell you the health of your SD card. You could toggle SD card recording on and off. You can set up a recording schedule. So right now I have it for continuous, but if I selected edit and then change my bullet to detection, I could start changing it where here during these times, I want detection notification, not continuous recording. So you could really customize this to notify you only when you want to know. Right here, we have record sound. In some areas, you might not be legally able to record audio with your video. That is how you toggle that on and off. Next is video and display. Right here, this is where we start getting to our night vision options. At the top, I have night vision boost on, so that's gonna really enhance things with the starlight sensor. But you can toggle that off if you want. Just know, if you do, then you lose access to some of these other night vision options. And they are viewing from a distance. So these are going to be your two different IR lights. So you've got outdoor for far viewing or indoor for close viewing, or set up our white light. So off by default, which is what I have it, only when an event is detected, meaning if something happens, motion, pet, whatever, then they turn on as long as it's dark to get a full color video of the event, or you have it always on. It's always going to happen. In my case, I'm going to leave it for the event and we're going to come back. Video quality, you're getting this for that crisp, clear 2K video. But notice right here, you can downgrade it to 1080, which is still considered HD. Invert image, because you can have your camera upside down, inverting the image means that it will flip it so that you can see the image correctly on the application, even though the camera is hanging upside down. Privacy zone, on or off. I'm gonna select this and show you what a privacy zone is. Let's say this hallway over here is something that I don't wanna see. I don't ever wanna see anything. Well, I would add a zone and I will take my privacy zone and move it right over there and select save. Now, in video recordings and when I view the live feed, I will not be able to see that area. Come back in here and you can always clear that and save. Privacy zones is a very powerful feature that a lot of other camera manufacturers make you pay for. Keep that in mind. Tapo, you don't have to pay for that. Coming down, we have our on-screen display information. Well, I like time and date stamp. You can have text. Text is kind of interesting in that if you have multiple Tapo cameras or you have multiple of the same camera, but you want to say, hey, in the video feed itself, burn in the location. So I could say warehouse 1 or docking bay 2. And that's what the text display would do. Tapo logo, as it sounds, it'll have the logo as part of the video. Here we have display tag on screen. So speed tag, that's that right there. And then live, if you wanted to do that. I appreciate the fact that they give you a sample video so that you know exactly what you're getting when you choose those options. Moving on, we have our spotlight settings. Selecting this, well, here we have our brightness level. I have it maxed out. If we wanted to test it, I could simply select that and you can see right there, it got really bright. If I lower that to 2, you'll notice shadows now. So I'm gonna use a light, I'm gonna make it maximum brightness. And then we have our duration. How long will this stay on? 5 minutes all the way up to 30 minutes. Next is our LED status light on or off. If you have this continuously recording, it will be a green steady light. If you have it set for triggered events only, it will be a red light that flashes once motion is detected. Here we have our networking information. Here we have privacy mode, yet another place to access it, which will again prevent everything from being seen. Now we have our notifications. I was having some work done at my house, so I actually turned this off. But if I turn on notification, I can select what type of notification I want. Do I want cat meowing, glass breaking, pet detection, person detection, motion detection? You have the ability to customize what you are getting notified of. That is one of the great things that I love about Tapo. The rich notification, which is a thumbnail along with the notification, this is where Tapo makes you pay. Again, not necessary, but there are some people who like that option. And then notification, send me them all the time, during the day only, during the night only, or custom duration. Advanced settings, well, here we have camera account. So if you wanted to set up a specific username and password for this camera, you could do that. Power line frequency, you have the ability 50 hertz, 60 hertz, or auto. If you don't know what that is, just let the camera decide, let it pick automatically. Same thing with the UPNP. If you don't know what it is, just stay out of there. But if you're looking for that feature, this is where it is. Voice call mode, you have standard mode, or you can select compatibility, which will ensure a better stable call quality, but might lower quality just a little bit. Display setting, similarly, hardware acceleration improves performance, but if you do compatibility mode, it will lower some things, making sure that you will stay connected. And then diagnostic, on or off. If you need to perform a diagnostic, that is how you can toggle that on or off. Share device, if I select this, well, I can share by selecting that, but the person will need to have their own TP-Link account, which I will then email a share code to. User guide right there. If you have any questions about the camera that this video hasn't answered for you, there is a user guide. You have your feedback right there if you wanted to send feedback to TP-Link about this particular Tapo camera. Firmware, I like this in that automatic update. You might have seen it when I was setting up the camera. If I select this, I can set up a specific time of day that the camera will automatically check for an update. And you set that really in the morning when nobody else is doing anything, so you don't have to worry about that being interrupted. You can manually, as you saw, check for an update and have the camera check if you needed to. We have the ability to reboot this camera and then remove this camera from my account. And those were all of the settings for Tapo C120. I'm going to bring you back to our Tapo homepage for one moment because you might not have realized Tapo made a very large change to their application in that you can now bring in all of your Casa hardware into one location. And I like the fact that they break them down. If you have cameras, here are all your cameras in one location. Do you have vacuums? There are your vacuums. Do you have smart, meaning do you have integrations or automations set up? This is where you can come to do that. Simply select the plus sign. You could set up an automation right there. I set up this automation using Casa, which you could see over there in the corner. And then me is going to be your account information. I like the fact that TP-Link has now unified their Casa line and their Tapo line into a single location for me. And now that has been everything that we can do with the Tapo application for the Tapo C120 camera.